people who took bodybuilding to the next level. Greg Valentino. Greg Valentino, also known as the man whose arms exploded, is one of the least liked people in the world of bodybuilding. He represented a world where bodybuilders completely depend on drugs, steroids and synthetic oil, injecting in order to make their body look bigger. Valentino went too far and his arm literally burst. His bicep got severely infected from a dirty needle and he attempted to perform a surgery on himself by cutting it open and drain the blood. Valentino has also been in and out for rehab and jail for the possession, distribution and uses of steroid. Mustafa Ismail. Mustafa Ismail is controversial 2013 Guinness World Records holder for the biggest bicep at 31 inches in diameter, which is about average size of a human waistline. According to Ismail, he doesn't abuse any steroid or other drugs. It is rather weird to see his arms in comparison to the rest of his body, which is in proportional to average size. Mustafa claimed to eat about 7 pounds of proteins each day, but the fitness community accused him injecting oil, known as synthol, directly into his arm. Sally McNeil. Sally McNeil got into the bodybuilding after she served in the Marine Corps. Her husband Ray was also involved in the sports. However, Sally's body and mind didn't react well to the massive amount of steroid and testosterone that she was injecting daily. She became prone to having what is known as a road rage, much of which resulted in several different people being beaten up. Sally also dropped a 70 pounds weight on her husband's car. In April of 1996, Sally shot Ray to death in the chest and is currently serving a life sentence. Marcus Ruhl. Marcus Ruhl currently has the biggest shoulder in the bodybuilding history and is believed to be one of the strongest as well. Ruhl trained for 5 years for his first competition and became quite the success in the fitness world. However, in 1999, he was disqualified from the Mr. Olympia competition after testing positive for the diuretic, which is a substance that promotes the production of urine by rejecting any forms of water that enters the body. Ruhl believed that his muscles and veins should pop out even more if he were able to dry his body from H2O. Gary Hemming. Gary Hemming was an Australian bodybuilder who was competing in IFBB competition in Victoria, Australia in 2009. Hemming had a heart attack and collapsed on the stage during his set. Despite official performing CPR, Hemming was pronounced dead at the hospital. What was even crazier was that the competition continues after Hemming was taken to the hospital. Hemming's death put another dark cloud over the bodybuilding's world and the health factor associated with the supplements and the drug abuse. Arlindo D'Souza. Arlindo D'Souza, aka the Mountain, is a Brazilian bodybuilder who is famous for his 29 inches fake biceps. Unlike Mustafa, D'Souza admit to using a cocktail of oil and alcohol that he regularly injected into his arms and upper body. Doctors have warned D'Souza that if he continues this, there is a high possibility of infections which will result in amputation. However, he has ignored this recommendation and continues to work out with his folded arm. You won't see D'Souza in the public gym. However, as he currently works out in the makeshift gyms in his yard, which is ironic considering his makeshift muscles. Andreas Munzer. Andreas Munzer is one of the most tragic deaths in the bodybuilding history. He never stopped his training, nor did he even take a break from his strict diet. Also, he has taken a diuretic and other drugs in order to maintain and improve his physique. In March of 1996, Munzer was experiencing severe stomach pains and was admitted in the hospital, and it turned out he was internal bleeding. Munzer's livers and kidneys shut down and Munzer died. After an autopsy, over 20 different drugs were found in his system. His liver was filled with tumor and his heart was twice the size of an average heart. Aziz Shevashin was a famous young Russian-Australian bodybuilder in the YouTube community. He established a cult following and became a fitness icon in the internet world. His subscribers worshipped him like a god, as they believe his gains were all natural. However, during a vacation in Thailand, Ziz suffered a heart attack inside a sauna. He was taken to the hospital, but doctors were not able to revive him. He died at the age of 22 from the heart failure, most likely linked to substance abuse. His death was announced on his Facebook page. Thanks for watching this video, and don't forget to smash like button before you switch to other videos of our channel. We are going to upload new videos on another topic, so stick around by subscribing our channel for more fascinating facts.